Let's start the day with a short prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to praise you and to thank you and to honor you this time. As we prepare our hearts, speak to us, Lord God, through the songs today. We'd like to empty our hearts. We'd like to empty our minds and speak to us today. And we just want to welcome your presence in our midst. Let your blessings overflow. And this is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Amen.
Wise and wonderful. The Lord God made them all.
Thank you. a wonderful relationship with God and each other. However, do you remember the angels God created? One of the angels became very proud. He wanted to be like God and to have the other angels worship him instead of God. But there is only one God to be worshipped. Therefore, God cast this disobedient angel out of him. We call that angel the devil. God also cast out of heaven all the other angels who followed him. They are demons or evil spirits. One day, the devil tempted the woman to eat the fruit from the one tree that was forbidden. He asked her, "Did God really say you couldn't eat from any tree in the garden?" The woman said, "No, you may eat of any tree except from the one tree in the middle of the garden. If we eat it or touch it, we will die." But the devil told her, "You won't die, but will instead become like God." The woman listened to the devil and ate the fruit. Then she gave it to her husband and he ate. That day, both of them sinned. Sin is any time we disobey God's commands. God is righteous and holy. He must punish us when we disobey him. God cast the man and the woman out of the garden, and their relationship with God was broken forever. Like that man and woman, all of us have sinned. Our relationship with God is broken, and the result of sin is eternal punishment in hell when we die. We cannot live forever with God as we were designed. What can be done? God still loved the people of the world very much. Therefore, at just the right time, God sent Jesus to show people how to mend their relationship with himself. Who is Jesus? Jesus is God's one and only Son.
Your baby boy, your walk through angels' rock. This little child is living. You kiss the face of God, Mary. Did you?
each one of us. Thank you all for coming. Listen up.
Yeah.
Jesus to die on the cross in our place. Jesus bore the punishment of all of our sins. Only through the shedding of blood can our sins be forgiven. Someone had to pay for our sins. After Jesus died that day, his friends took his body and placed it in a secure tomb. However, this story doesn't end here. On the third day after this, Jesus rose from the dead and spent many days showing people that he was alive again. He proved that he was the Son of God. Then he returned to his Father in heaven. Jesus took our punishment and now provides a way for us to come back to God. Only he can show us the way back to God.
pa kay picture na sino ko edit.
When the man next to me saw the book in my hand and asked me what it was about, so I settled back in my seat, a bestseller, I said, a history and mystery in one. Then I opened up the book and began to read from Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. He was born of a virgin on a holy night in the little town of Bethlehem.
To give reverence to the Word of God, I request everyone to stand.
If you have your Bibles with you in English, Urdu, Hindi, or Arabic, I would like you to read it. Or whatever language you speak. Malayalam, perhaps. If you have your Bibles with you in Malayalam, we'll read it together. I'll be reading from Alberti in English. Are you there? Okay, we'll be reading from the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 to 20. Altogether, in those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that there will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, the Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which they were just as they had been told. The word of the Lord. You may take your seats.
Oh, Oh,
world.